you're living my worst nightmare, being evaluated by four people. So first of all, I have to say you're a very brave woman. I would never want to be in your shoes. I gotta say, I liked your speech, and I liked your speech. You could have given a speech about the history of why this wall was white, and I would have liked it. Because you got a great smile, you had a laugh in it, and seriously, if you can talk about anything, and if you're up here and you have a smile and you do it in a way that's friendly and everybody's looking at you and it's engaging, it's going to be a good speech. It doesn't even matter what you're talking about. And so I like that. I thought just because of that, just because of your composure and your facial expressions, your body language here, that made this speech good, and it's going to make any speech that you do in the future also good. I like the examples. I especially like the example of freezing the eggs. It hits personal for me because I have five people that work in my team, and two of them are pregnant. I would love to offer them the opportunity to freeze their eggs. So fantastic idea. I'm going to recommend this for my company tomorrow. But what I would say in terms of how to improve, I think the introduction, don't start out with my topic is this. You gotta just go to the website on Toastmasters. They have some recommendations on how to do a more creative, a more interesting introduction, or just go on the web and you get some ideas. You can do it with quotes, story. There's a hundred different ways, but don't come out and say what your topic is. Just try and come up with something more creative than that next time. In terms of the language, of course, I'm a native speaker. I have to say something about that. It's an obligation. Here's what I'll say is that we all deal with speaking in a foreign language in a different way, okay? And so some of us are perfectionists, and we work with native language people, and we memorize every single word so that we don't make a mistake. And some of them are like you, where you're very comfortable up here, but then you make some mistakes when you're saying it. And so I think the best thing for us is to try and find a point in the middle. That's really what we need to do with this piece, is try and find a point in the middle. And so moving forward, like I said, you're always going to give a good speech just because that's part of who you are and that's how you deliver a speech. So go work on this introduction, look up some ways to do some different things with the introduction. And then for the next one, I would say try and talk to somebody who is a native English speaker or a Spanish speaker who you know speaks good English, just to review it. You don't have to memorize all the words, but just to write it well. And that's part of the way that you're going to improve the English as well, which I think is part of the reason why you do it. But overall, it's really good, so congratulations.